Hey guys, welcome. In today's video, I'm going to show you 5 things that you should definitely not do in an automatic transmission vehicle. Let's get started now. Alright guys, so in this modern age when a lot of us are driving automatic cars, I thought it makes sense to make this video to make sure that all of us make the correct practices and don't do anything that can actually damage an automatic gearbox. Alright guys, so let's start off with something which many of you are definitely going to call controversial. We are coming up to red signal now. After I come to a stop, should I put the vehicle in neutral or parking, or should I leave it and drive with my foot on the brake? Well, if you guys have not already seen my video on the different types of automatic transmissions, you can do so by clicking over here. But now, I'm going to explain something different. So right now, in a vehicle with a torque converter automatic or a CVT automatic, it doesn't matter whether you leave it in drive or neutral when you come to a stop at a red light. If you have a DSG or an AMT gearbox, I do recommend you put the vehicle in neutral and either keep your foot on the brake or put the parking brake if you come to a long red light. Do note that these modern luxury cars do have something called auto hold, wherein you come to a stop with your foot on the brake, the vehicle automatically puts the vehicle in hold and you can take a leg off the brake. In these modern vehicles, it doesn't really matter whether you put the vehicle in neutral or leave it in drive, because the onboard technology takes care of you then. Right guys, now many of us think that automatic transmission fluid need not be changed at all during the lifetime of the car. But this is not true. If we check the maintenance booklet of the vehicle over here, we can clearly see that it says right here, manual, automatic, and we must change the automatic transmission fluid over here. So guys, this is another thing which many of us take for granted, and this in the long run will definitely cause damage to your gearbox. Now I'm going to talk about something called launching. Now we all know in a manual transmission vehicle, put the vehicle in neutral, build up the revs, put first gear, dump the clutch, and off you go with a nice big wheel spin launch. In an automatic car, however, that's not possible because, well, let's put it in drive. Oh wait, put it in neutral, handbrake on. You rev it, it does rev up. However, if you're going to do something called a neutral drop, wherein you rev it up in neutral, suddenly put drive and go, that is definitely going to destroy your transmission. So, in an automatic car, do not launch it like that. If you do want to launch it, do this. Put it in drive or put it in sports mode. You can put your left foot on the brake, build up the rev slightly, and go like that. So this is the best way to launch an automatic car if you don't have launch control and if you don't want to destroy your automatic gearbox. And guys, another important thing when it comes to automatic transmission vehicles. Let's assume you're going to take a 3-point turn. So make sure you come to a stop first, a complete stop, before engaging reverse gear. Do not engage reverse gear when the vehicle is moving. In a manual transmission car, yes, you can do that because you have the clutch to disengage the gearbox. In an automatic vehicle, always remember to come to a complete stop first before you engage the particular gear. Right guys, and this brings us to the final point in this video. Now let's say you've reached your destination and you're going to turn off your car. What do you do? Do you just put it in park straight away? No. What you do, you put it in neutral, put the handbrake up to take the strain from the gearbox. Then, if you want, you can just put it in park and then switch the vehicle off. Or in my case, switch the vehicle off and then put it in park. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and this is also my first kind of vlog, so there will be a lot of errors in it. If so, do forgive me and leave a comment on how to make this better. Thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and bye-bye.